This year's Nobel Peace Prize has gone to Indian Kailash Satyarthi.
I am a simple child rights worker. Let us begin with children. Save one generation, and then that generation would be able to save all generations. When I was entering in my classroom, I saw a cobbler boy sitting outside the school gate along with his father. And that was so shocking for me because I was told and taught that every child was supposed to go to school. It was disturbing that why this child is sitting outside. Every morning and afternoon I was watching that boy, and that made me more angry. And then slowly I gathered all my courage. And one day when I was returning back from school, I stopped and asked him and his father. When I asked that, why don't you send your son to school? He said, you are born to go to school, but we are born to work. And that made me even more angry and sad. I could not believe and I could not accept that some children are born to work at the cost of their education and freedom. And that had given me a different perspective of life. Some people are treated untouchables in the society. That was another injustice which I could not accept. So I thought that why can't we organize a feast to celebrate Mahatma Gandhi's birth centenary in 1969 and invite the suppress women who were considered untouchables to come and cook food which could be eaten by the high caste leaders, because leaders used to speak so high, this is wrong, this is untouchability must go from the country. And I thought that they are great people and they can come and eat, but nobody turned up, not a single person. It was another revelation in my life that how hypocrite was the society. I was socially outcasted and my family was forced to give me a separate room. My food, utensils and water and everything was separated. But that night I decided that who are they to outcast me? Everybody is human being born in one caste, and then that caste is humanity, that caste is human being. So I decided to give up my surname or family name, which is normally the caste name. And later on I gave new name, Satyarthi, to myself, and that means seeker of truth. People thought slavery has been abolished and child labor was a common phenomena, so it was not really accepted as a kind of evil or a crime. So I tried to educate the people by way of publishing a magazine which was devoted for the cause of these children and women. One day, a desperate father knocked my door whose daughter was about to be sold to a brothel. 17 years ago, he and his newly married wife and some other people were taken to work at a brick kiln where they were confined as slaves. All children were born and grew up there, including 15-year-old Sabo. I realized that if she was my sister or my daughter, what would I do? I'm not going to simply write and wait. I will hold the whole world upside down. So I decided and I told him that, look, I'm going to rescue Sabo. He said, no, these people are mafia, they will kill you and me. I said, whatever happens. So I went to Sumedha, my wife, back home, requested her to give her wedding ornaments so that we can hire a truck, because he said that there were about 30, 40 people and other logistics. We were also badly handled and beaten and forced to leave. But I did not give up. I never believe in giving up. So I went to the court. Then the court has released all those people from slavery. Sabo and 35 others, 36 people. And all these children who were born in slavery, you can't believe that when they were coming out from the court, they were jumping on the streets like, you know, you hold the monkeys for whole of their life and suddenly, leave from the lease and things like that. And some mothers were hugging them and tears were rolling down on their cheeks. And in those tears of joy and the smile of freedom, I could feel the glimpse of God. I believe in liberty. I believe in freedom of every human being. If I believe in that, it should be my conviction. If you do it for your conviction, then you should be prepared to sacrifice. I had to pay the cost. I was beaten up many times. My left leg is broken, my right shoulder is broken, my backbone is broken, my children were attacked, my house was attacked, my office was burned, and two of my colleagues were shot dead. One was shot dead, one was beaten to death. But each time when they tried to destroy me, defame me, kill me, I felt more stronger from inside. In most cases, the greediness to earn easy money, cheap money, by way of employing children or making them slave, is the biggest driver in their minds. It was a big shock when somebody called me up and said, Kailash ji, Nobel Prize, you won the Nobel Prize. So it was a surprise for me. But once when you become the Nobel Laureate, then they say that you have access to everything. Nobel. You can enter in the minds and hearts and houses and offices to everyone. Nobel. You need not to ring the bell. The very first initiative came in rug industry through my efforts. I found that there were many consumers who wanted to buy clean products. And then also I realized that there were not many, but few exporters, importers, manufacturers of rugs who were prepared to make child labor free rugs. I tried to bring them closer and build a movement to educate consumers, but also educate the industry back in early 90s. And that has resulted in the first social labeling named Rugmark, now known as Good Weave. And that has helped in reducing the number of child laborers from 1 million to hardly 200,000 in South Asian rug industry. And that has inspired many other industries to find some solutions. The consumer consciousness is pushing hard the industries to find some solutions. Join 100 million campaign to be the change makers and leaders, because I tell everyone, don't look for the leaders outside. Don't look for the icons outside, champions outside. There is a hero inside each one of you. Identify that hero and strengthen it to be a change maker. Change is inside, change is outside, just match it.